the host with the most of the most pointless game on TV. Yeah, it's called Pointless and it's an absolute blast. We, of course, are talking about the fabulous Mark Humphries, and he joins us now. Come on down!
Look at these beautiful people. Hello.
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 How are you?
Mark,
my God.
Look that was
you.
A real game show run on.
It has
to be.
It's what people expect.
Yeah, exactly. The half Tony Barber there.
Yeah.
A little trot, a little spring in your step.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. Yeah. No, and you've got the bit of the Baby John going.
I do have a bit of the Baby John. Yeah, I'm thinking, what do you think?
Classic Virgo. Now, I saw at the start of the show you were talking about shaving it off. Where are we at with that?
There's controversy, it's fair to say. There's a movement on. You thought the riots in France were bad. You got
right.
Hashtag kids, #MoToo.
That's it. And kids were protesting. Well, isn't that what they were doing? They were protesting shaving off the mustache.
That's right.
Is that what it was about? Yeah.
The great existential crisis that's facing the globe.
I believe
that's
they were doing it on the Monington Peninsula.
Now, listen, we came on your show a little while back and we played a bit of a game of Pointless. It was actually really, really fun. How do you think we went?
I thought you were the most attractive contestants we've had.
That's bad,
very,
huh?
Very stylish. No, you obviously, I mean, you both got correct answers, so you and Anne's routine. Joe, you were with Peter Burner, so we had two correct answers.
Yes.
Which is sometimes as good as we can expect. So that was tremendous, and I think you and Peter came out on top.
Yeah,
so
we did. Yeah, well, look, I'm not a competition, but actually it is a competition, and yes, we won. Because it's a great show, I love it, it is very addictive. Did you find it hard at the beginning to explain to people the whole point of the game is to not get points?
Yeah, yes, absolutely. I think that's still an ongoing struggle with certain people. Yeah, I think sometimes it's easier to explain it sort of as a reverse family feud of, yes, we've surveyed 100 people, but we don't want the answer that everyone came
that's right.
up with. We want the ones that are more obscure.
And preferably that no one came
exactly,
up with.
Exactly, exactly right. It's not about just getting a correct answer, it's about getting the correct answer that no one else thought of.
And this is your 100th episode this Friday.
Yes.
Have you amassed just a huge amount of meaningless, pointless trivia in your brain now?
You'd think so, but if anything, I've lost knowledge. No, I've retained nothing. I know a lot about Andrew Rochford. I can tell you a lot about
Andrew. There's a bit of a bromance going on between you two.
Well, he's a very handsome man.
Yeah,
very handsome man.
So are you.
Yeah, well, but, I mean, Andrew Rochford, can we hear it for Andrew Rochford?
Yeah, I'm too. So they like you.
And he's an emergency doctor.
There you go. He's the full package.
With, twins and children, so he's managed to tick a whole bunch of those boxes.
Yeah. However, we do know that you're a very funny comedian as well.
You've done
this character based on Barnaby Joyce. You're going to be wheeling him out again for The Chaser, is that right?
Yes, so currently touring with your good friend Charles
Firth. She's got him on speed dial.
Right. I think everyone does after you get his number out. But so I'm touring with Charles and some other great satirists as well. And we're going around the country. We just did Adelaide. So sorry if you've missed us in Adelaide. But Melbourne, Canberra, Brisbane and Sydney, we've got shows coming up. But yes, I have a character loosely inspired by Barnaby Joyce called Barabbas Loins.
Let's have a look at him. Let's have a look.
Please. I'm Nationals MP Barabbas Loins, member for Oppleseed and minister for mulch. In my travels around Australia, people always ask me, Barabbas, when are you going to release an explosive political memoir that makes the perfect Father's Day gift? To those figments of my imagination, I say, good news, my book is coming out next month. It's going to be part memoir, part thriller, all cash grab. Best of all, it will be available from all good bookstores, but mainly secondhand on Gumtree. Not the website, up an actual Gumtree.
Has he got into contact with you about that at all?
No, and I think it's probably best we keep it that way.
Okay.
Yeah, I think
so
giving
if you're
respectful
going to an
distance,
airport, run.
That's basically it, yeah.
I love those clips you do. There was one you did just last week, which was also extremely funny, and your impersonation of a tabloid editor was actually so bang on the money. I thought you must have been at the last newsroom meeting I was at.
Yeah, I did do a sketch about a year ago, which was behind the scenes of the Sydney's Daily Telegraph.
Great newspaper.
And I've been told that I managed to capture certain elements.
It was uncanny. It was like
even though I've never met him or what have you. So look it up on YouTube, please. yes, but so yes, Barabbas Loins will be performing excerpts from his memoir, Loins, Warts and All. and his publisher wishes to clarify that it's not all about STIs. But sorry, carry on.
Look, you are getting a lot of spread. Your name is everywhere.
Speaking of loins.
Yes, yeah, boom, Tish.
Sarah.
This is actually, this is incredible, a moment from Parliament. Look at this.
Both the Prime Minister and I are having a session with Mark Humphries shortly. But look, the reality is the economy is a serious business.
You're now in Hansard
there
forever.
You go. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so just for context, so I'd done a couple of sketches where, if you've seen Josh Frydenberg and Scott Morrison, their social media team are pumping out a lot of video content.
Quality stuff, isn't it?
That's generous, Ange. That's generous. So, you know, Josh's head is too close to the camera and it's all a little bit stilted and forced. And so I sent that up and I played a sort of the director, sort of the visionary behind these videos. And anyway, the Prime Minister retweeted the one that I did about him. Josh Frydenberg responded to the one that I did about him. And then, yes, it came up in Parliament. So I have nothing left to live for
this now. This is in your work on the ABC. So you spread yourself about a bit network-wise. You're not exactly a...
I think it's important.
A one channel lad.
Yeah, no, I think it's important to also take money from the taxpayer from time to time.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent.
It's important.
Yeah.
It's a public-private partnership.
And are you part of the inquiry now with Michelle Guthrie?
Oh, no, but I'm sure I'll be, you know, sending
it up.
I'm sure
you could have your views.
I'm keeping my distance from that for the moment.
Oh, come on.
But if they need a managing director,
Do you do a Julian Milne?
Justin Milne.
Justin Milne.
No,
sorry. As chairman.
You should do that.
I'll come back to you, Kerri-Anne.
Yeah. Okay. There's an idea for
you. He's quit now. There's nothing you can do.
No, this is right.
Except,
he's got no power.
Except for the defamation laws around Australia. So I'll save you from that.
Please.
Pointless is looking for some more contestants, I believe.
Yes, yes. Please come on, Pointless. Go to, I think, Pointless. I should know the website.
Pointlesscasting.com.au.
Thank God for straps. So, yes, if you are someone who shouts at the screen and you think you know the answers, please come on. Obviously, we take teams, so if you've got a good dynamic with your mother-in-law or, you know, a colleague or what have you, and anyone just who wants to have a bit of fun, we'd really love to have you.
What do you say, Harris? We could do it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, he wouldn't let me get a word in, though.
Come on. No. Sarah, please. Please.
It all goes back to Roman times.
You can catch Pointless Week.
The public era.
You can catch Pointless Weeknights at 6 on the 10 and Win Networks. And the 100th episode of the show is this Friday, which is super, super exciting for you, Mark. Well done. And you can also catch Mark on tour with The Chaser during the rest of December. The details are on your screen now.
My love.
I will.
How about you stick around and get a bit of the morning TV treatment?
I would love to, Sarah. Thank you so much.
Mark Humphries, everyone.